Now in the second session, we will study in detail exactly how to evaluate the performance of, sorry, efficiency of Carnot heat engine. I am Professor Vivek Sathe of Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Now before we start, we must know what is the outcome of this session. Now here we are learning to evaluate the efficiency of a Carnot heat engine, which already you know from the basics of thermodynamics. But we'll now highlight certain important issues of it, and then we'll proceed further. Okay, in the last session, we have seen that Carnot proposed a cycle which consisted of two isothermals and two isentropes. So on the TS diagram, we have shown that 1, 2, 3, 4, it is 1, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4, and 1, this one. Okay. Now, the concept of 1T engine, 1T engine. Now, what is the meaning of 1T? 1T means an engine interacting only with one reservoir. Means if I take one reservoir, T1, and then it is, say, producing certain amount of work, that is W, is not valid thermodynamically. So, there must be minimum two, T for the engines. What is the meaning of minimum 2T? Means there must be reservoir, one which from which heat is being taken. There is another reservoir to which heat is being rejected. Then we can have an engine. Now naturally the question comes, if I ask you, is it possible to have an engine with 3T? That is three temperature reservoirs? Why not? We can. So generally we say that NT engine, N is greater than 1, is the valid definition of heat engine. Means if I have N reservoirs, so how it will look like? Very simple. I have got one reservoir T1, I have got second reservoir T1, T2, I have got second, third reservoir T3, I have got another two reservoirs. Say this is T1, this is T2, this is T3, this is T4, and this is T5. I arbitrarily can give some temperatures, but my question is, it can take heat from this, it can take heat from this, then it can reject heat to this, it can reject heat to this, it can take heat from this, and so on. So finally, this engine is such that it is taking heat from so many reservoirs. Now theoretically, say conceptually, it is very difficult to identify such an engine where we can supply heat from the four sources, but it is feasible. Just I give an assignment or an idea that you just think over it, that how we can have a 3T engine, or how we can have a 4T engine. And you come across such numericals when we say we are going to solve the problems, and you will get an idea that it is possible. But there is a difference. Carnot efficiency that we are going to devise or say evaluate today is valid only for a 2T engine. So first thing is, Carnot engine or Carnot efficiency is valid only for 2T engine. Then whether engine works or not, how we can check with Carnot efficiency equation? So there is another, say, very good concept in thermodynamics, which is known as Clausius inequality. Now what is Clausius inequality? Clausius inequality says that dQ by T is less than or equal to 0. Now dQ by T, if it is a process is reversible, we call this as an entropy. See, don't make a confusion regarding the concept of entropy S and dQ by T. One thing is clear, as long as heat transfer is taking place at reversible condition, the dQ by T becomes entropy. Otherwise, it is not. So if my process is reversible, I can say that dQ by T is entropy and dQ by T is less than or equal to 0. To make it more comprehensive, Carnot, that Clausius added that you can have this one dQi, I equal to 1 to n. Now what has happened? After what is the engine? Engine is nothing but it is heat and work interaction. Is it not? So when heat and work interactions are there, can we restrict it to only two? No. One is not valid because it is thermodynamically not acceptable. Then two is a Carnot engine, and for two we have got a Carnot efficiency. But that too, we can again say discuss here in detail that sometimes the numbers say that yes, first law is valid, then Carnot efficiency is also giving some number, but whether this particular engine works or not, if you want to check it, either you have to find out the Carnot efficiency of the engine, and we have to check the efficiency of our engine, and if that efficiency is less than Carnot engine, we will say that yes, that engine will work. But instead of that, if you use the Clausius inequality, we will get a better result. If you sum all the heat interactions with the reservoirs, dQ by T, and add them together, and if their net sum is less than 0 or equal to 0, if it is equal to 0, it is a reversible engine. If it is, say, less than 0, it is irreversible engine, then the system will definitely work. That part we will see in detail when we discuss about this engine. Now, but first of all, we will now go for finding out the expression for efficiency of the Carnot engine. That is our today's task. Once again, I draw here TS. Now, what I do, instead of writing the numbers, that is, say, 1, 2, 3, 4, that I will write as for the processes, 1, 2, 3, and 4, I will write this temperature as TH and this temperature as TL. Now, what has happened? This is the lowest temperature, this is the highest temperature. I know that this is the heat supplied to the engine and this is the heat rejected. That in the first slide, we have already seen it. Now, in this process, what happens? What is the efficiency of an engine? It is the work done upon heat supply. This is a classic definition. This is the classic definition of engine. Now, what is work? It is the heat supplied minus heat rejected upon heat supplied. Heat supplied minus heat rejected upon heat supplied. Now, this will give me idea 1 minus Q rejected upon Q supplied. Okay. Now, Carnot cycle is a reversible cycle. So, on the TS diagram, I can have heat supplied in the form of area under the curve. Now, if I ask you, what is the heat rejected? It is area under this curve. It is area under this curve. So, this will represent the heat rejected. This shaded area will represent the heat rejected. And if I want to see that what is the heat supplied, so heat supplied is this for this process, and this green area will represent the heat supplied. Now, I will come to the basic point. Now, if I say heat rejected, so it is a perfect rectangle. So, area of the rectangle I know. So, it is equal to 1 minus, it is the lowest temperature into S3 minus S1 divided by TH into S4 minus S1, and this is S3 minus S2. This is my expression. Now, you know that S4 minus S1 and S3 minus S2, they are same. They are same because it is a rectangle. So, I can cancel them. And what I get is equal to 1 minus TL upon TH. So, 1 minus TL upon TH is the expression for efficiency of a Carnot engine. Then, there are certain corollaries that already you have studied, that this Carnot efficiency is the maximum efficiency if you have any heat engine operating between two reservoirs. Now, the question comes, if I have an engine operating between TH and TL and its efficiency is greater than, say, Carnot efficiency, will it be feasible or not? So, we'll discuss that part here now. Now, let us assume that TH, highest temperature, is equal to, say, 600, lowest temperature is equal to 300. Of course, I am talking in terms of Kelvin. That numbers I have taken for convenience so that I can get some good number figure. Now, if I calculate the efficiency of this engine, it will be TL is 300, this is 600, so my efficiency is going to be 50%. Okay, means if I got 500, 600, and 300, my efficiency is 50%. What is the meaning of this? If I have got this T1, this T2 at 600. This is at 300, and suppose I take 100 joules from this temperature, I can reject 50 joules to the lowest reservoir and I can get the work of 50. Now, this is a valid expression. Now, whether this engine is reversible or not, that we don't know, because cannot assume that it is a reversible engine, we have done it. But in case if it is not reversible, then what will happen to this 50? What is your guess? The guess is 50 number that we have got is the maximum limit for the work that your engine will give. Now suppose I say that it rejects 60 and gives 40 as a work output. Is it a valid engine? Yes, it is a valid engine. But suppose it gives 40 as a rejection and 60 as an output, it is not valid. Now how it is valid, not invalid? Cannot engine or cannot efficiency expression only restricts the maximum efficiency. But who will tell you positively that yes, this engine will not work? So this is a class, that is classes inequality. So that part we will discuss in the next session in detail. Okay. Now just to review, in the first two sessions, that is session one and session two, now you have got a confidence that for IC engines, Carnot engine is a standard engine, it is a 2T engine, it works on four processes, all are internally reversible as well as externally reversible, two isothermals and two adiabatics. Then the efficiency that we can calculate using the TS plot, because area under the curve represents the heat supplied, and the expression we get is a very standard expression, 1 minus TL by TH, which will give the maximum efficiency for an engine operating between two reservoirs. Any engine operating having efficiency greater than that is not feasible, but cannot tell it by some solid reasons like entropy and other things. It is a fact. Nobody has disproved it. So this part you have learnt in detail. In the next session, we will see the Clausius inequality. We will take some interesting changes in the temperatures of the TL and TH and see what happens to the efficiency of an engine. And so that we can say, see what is the scope for improving further. Those who are interested in studying further, they can refer the IC engine by Jan Heywood and internal combustion engine by Gupta. So thank you for this particular, say, part of the session. We'll meet next time, next session.